What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. This is Aki. Today, we are in Sabah, a state of East Malaysia located on the northern part of Borneo. Personally, this is my third time visiting Sabah, but there has always been a new discovery, and I find myself keep coming back here for more. This time, I'm gonna be staying here for 9 days. Throughout the journey, I'll be sharing with you guys the most remarkable destinations and activities you can do in Sabah. Are you guys ready for it? Let's get right to it. We took a rapid boat at Sandakan Jetty and headed to our first destination, Langkayang Island. Langkayang Island is a tiny jewel-shaped island located on the northeastern coast of Sabah. The island is part of the Sugut Island Marine Conservation Area and is surrounded by blue-green waters and coral reefs. Langkayang Island Dive Resort offers exciting water sports, such as snorkeling, scuba diving, and kayaking. The weather is perfect. I cannot wait to dive into the crystal clear water. Langkayang Island Dive Resort has been making efforts to protect crane and hawksbill turtles. The peak season for their hatching is from July to October, and today we are lucky enough to watch their release to the sea. There are hundreds of baby turtles being released today, but only a small portion of them will survive to adulthood. In fact, the survival rate of wild turtles is said to be only 0.1%. We have just witnessed the beautiful yet harsh reality of the nature. The sunset view in Langkayang Island is breathtakingly beautiful. The sky is completely dyed red, as if it's burning. All I hear is sound of ocean. This is one of my favorite places on earth, where I can forget about everything and immerse myself into the moment. Now we are back in Sandakan. Sandakan used to be the capital city of Sabah, and was famously regarded as the Little Hong Kong due to its history of being largely populated by Hong Kong immigrants. About 3 km away from the Sandakan city center, Sim Sim Water Village is a complex of hundreds of wooden stilt houses on the sea. It is divided into over 20 zones and each zone is connected by a walkway. You can enjoy walking through the colorful houses and eating some fresh seafood dishes. In the morning, you will see many local people buying fresh vegetables, fruits, meat and fishes at Sandakan Central Market, one of the most important seafood landing ports of Sabah. There are a variety of seafood, such as fish, crabs, rays, prawns, seashells, and squids. Spanning 560 km from southwest Sabah to the Sulu Sea, east of Sandakan, Kinabatangan River is the second longest river in Malaysia. Along the banks, thick green rainforest provides a home for a wide variety of animals such as macaques, lizards, elephants, and the famous Brabanosus monkeys. In fact, Kinabatangan River has the highest wildlife concentration in Borneo. Sepilok Orangutan Rehabilitation Center was founded in 1964 in the aim of helping young orangutans return to the wild. Due to illegal hunting and deforestation in Borneo, more than 100,000 orangutans were said to be lost between 1999 and 2015. The organization provides medical care for orphaned orangutans, as well as dozens of other wildlife species, including sun bear, at the adjoining Borneo Sun Bear Conservation Center. Now we are flying to Kota Kinabalu, the capital city of Sabah. It is one of the major industrial and commercial centers of East Malaysia. Located about 90 km away from the city center, Kinabalu National Park is the first UNESCO World Heritage Site in Malaysia. Kinabalu National Park boasts one of the richest collections of biodiversity in the world, housing and protecting more than 4,500 species of plants and animals. And of course, it is the home of Mount Kinabalu, the highest mountain in Malaysia. It is as high as 4,095 meters. Tomorrow we're gonna climb that mountain. I'm sure it's gonna be one of the hardest challenges in my life. Today we are gonna stay overnight at the cottage inside Kinabalu Park called Stera Sanctuary Lodges. They provided us with their finest stay, Kinabalu Lodge. This luxurious and spacious lodge features three separate bedrooms. It comes with a living and dining area and a fully furnished kitchen. This is a perfect place to take a good rest and prepare for the challenge that will start tomorrow. Except I was too excited about filming the rooms and couldn't sleep enough. Next morning we had breakfast at a nearby restaurant and headed to the starting point by a car. It's time to conquer Mount Kinabalu. It takes 2 days, 1 night to climb Mount Kinabalu. Today we are gonna climb onto the base camp and take a little rest there. Then tomorrow morning, we will climb all the way up to the summit of the mountain. It's quite chilly in the beginning of the climb, but as you climb higher, the steps get steeper and it makes you sweat a lot. Plus the weather in Mount Kinabalu is unpredictable, so it's better to bring layers so that you can adjust to the environment. It usually takes 4 to 5 hours to the base camp, and there are several rest points on the way. We had a lunch at a shelter around 3 kilometers from the starting point. It's really important to stay hydrated and get enough energy to keep your body moving. Along the trail, you can spot unique plants and animals that we can't usually see in daily life. At the higher altitude, we start to see more rocks on the trail. This should be a sign that we are getting close to the goal. After 4 hours of climbing, we finally made it to Panalaban Base Camp. Tomorrow morning, we will leave the base camp for the summit at 2 a.m., so we took an early sleep. But when we woke up, we found that it was raining outside. Due to the rocky and steep trail to the summit, even small rain can be extremely dangerous. We anxiously crossed our fingers and waited for the green light. We waited until 3 a.m., and here's the last call from the officer.
So, for your information guys, once we announce that we cross to get, no one, you go up to the peak, okay? For your safety, okay? Understand?
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
There's no choice but to accept it. We human beings are just helpless against the power of nature. In the morning, we watched the sunrise from Panalaban Base Camp. Despite that mixed feeling of sadness and frustration, we truly enjoyed a beautiful moment created by the magnificent nature. Now we are back in the city of Kota Kinabalu. One of the major attractions in the city is the waterfront night market. Consisting of a night market, handicraft shops, and a hawker center, it is managed mostly by locals and immigrants originating from the southern island of Philippines. You can enjoy the lively atmosphere of the market and interacting with its friendly staff. By the way, the seafood here is incredibly fresh and delicious. Today is the last day in Sabah. Mari Mari Cultural Village is located deep in the countryside away from the Kota Kinabalu city. The village operates as a museum in the aim of preserving the knowledge, history, culture, and tradition of Borneo so that they will not be forgotten. The village tour offers you the opportunity to see and experience the culture and lifestyle of how the indigenous ethnic groups of Borneo used to live in the old days, with no electricity or modern inventions. There are many settings for us to see, hear, taste, and feel the uniqueness of what Sabah truly is. At the end of our journey, Sabah Tourism invited us to dinner on Sunset North Borneo Cruise. We departed from Stera Marina Jetty at 5 p.m. and sailed across the South China Sea. We had a delicious Malaysian buffet dinner while enjoying the live band music together with all the other passengers. This trip has been full of exciting adventures and discoveries. My journey in Sabah has just begun and it will continue in the future. Not to mention, Mount Kinabalu gave me one more reason to come back here. Sabah, till I see you again.